This is the MKS Gen L board. It's a motherboard used for 3D printing. I'm going to give you a basic tutorial of what's on it, and in future videos I'll give a more in-depth discussion of each. So these are stepper driver ports. A board would connect to these. So we have our X, Y, Z, then we have our E0 and our E1. Behind each one of these, we have four sets of pins in the red, blue, green, black, and purple. Each one of these will take a connection for a NEMA 17 stepper driver motor. This white port over here is an auxiliary power port. It can either be powered as 12 or 24 volts, depending upon your input power. Our input power is over here. This obviously takes either 12 or 24 volts. Then we have our output power for our bed right here. Then we have our two extruders, and then we have a fan for output power. Over here, we have four sets of pins in front of each one of the steppers. This is to allow us an auxiliary driver pin ports to drive an additional axis. For instance, if we're on the X or Y or Z axis in this case, we can add an additional stepper to have a second stepper driver pair that will help you drive your Z axis. Over here we have our end stops. We have our red, blue, and green, and that corresponds to X, Y, and Z. In here, this one would be X min, this would be X max, this would be Y min, Y max, Z min, and Z max. Then we have our set of pins for an LCD. One is EXP1 and the other one is EXP2. Then we have our auxiliary 1 port, our auxiliary 2 pins, and our auxiliary 3 pins. Over here we have 3 pins that go in a row of 4. These are for servos, so you can connect servos over here. Then we have our purple, white, and black connections. There's a pair of pins in each. These are used for our thermistor connections for our heat beds and our extruders. Over here we have our programming port or our serial USB connection port. Then we have our spy pins here, and our reset pin right here. Over here, we have a 5-volt power pin and a ground pin, as well as a 5-volt here and a ground pin as well. In future videos, I'll show you more about this, but in a moment, I'll show you how to connect the USB serial and program with the firmware. This is the serial cable used to connect to the board and communicate. So to connect it, we're gonna connect the USB for this side and take the other side and connect it to the computer. Now keep in mind, you don't want to touch the board once you've powered it. And in a moment, I'll show you how to load firmware on the board. Okay, in order to load the firmware, we need to go into the Marlin folder for Marlin 1.1.8. Open up Marlin, press the letter M, scroll down to where it says Marlin.ino, and hit enter. Okay, we're in the Marlin firmware. Now I gotta point out some points of interest. We have our configuration.h tab. This is where 99% of our configuration will take place most of the time. And then we have our configuration_adv.h, which is configuration.advanced.h. So I'm not going to load any changes to the firmware, but I'm just going to show you how to load the firmware. So the first thing we need to do is check to see that we have the right board. And in this case, it has a similar architecture as the Arduino Mega 2560, so we'll select that. And then we'll make sure that we have a COM port selected, which we do, which is COM4. So we have two buttons here. We have a verify button, which verifies that it compiles without error. And then we have an upload button. Now, if you press the upload button, it will compile first and verify the build, and then it will upload. So I'm going to press this in order to upload the firmware. So this is going to take several moments. So I'm going to thank you for your time and watching my video. And please like and subscribe, and I'll speed up the rest for you.